Hey guys, and welcome back to more Fire Emblem Echoes. Today we're gonna do the last DLC of Rise of the Deliverance. But before that, I forgot on the last video to show the Python's bow. As you can see, it's just an iron bow. With probably some hidden skills that I don't know what they do because I haven't bothered unlocking them. But yeah, today we're gonna do Siege of Sophia Castle. It's probably where the shit hits the fan for the deliverance.
The troops are in position, Sir Slade.
Good. Chancellor Desaye needs to learn to finish what he starts. Oh, he managed to put King Lima to the sword, which is well and good. But then he suffers one minor defeat and flees to his fortress? I still can't fathom how 500 knights managed to rout an army of 3,000. But they're knights no more. This deliverance. They're no better than a pack of rebels, and soon to be dead ones at that. Let the artless fools cry for justice all they want. All the powerful houses have already pledged their banners to the Chancellor. The Kingdom of Sophia is as good as his. And this time, we've brought a siege army thrice as strong. Let's see those rats hold the castle walls against 10,000 men. It's only a matter of time now before their defenses buckle.
Clive! Desaye's forces have finished assembling outside the castle. They could storm us at any time.
I see. I'd like to think we have an advantage inside these walls, but... well, against such numbers, words like bleak spring to mind. We'll simply have to focus on holding the castle with minimal casualties.
Well said, my love. The king has fallen. If Desaye manages to seize the castle as well, then his control of the kingdom will be all but assured. That is the one thing we cannot allow. But at least the enemy only has so many points of incursion. If we focus our defenses around those, we could thwart two armies.
I do hope so.
What is it?
Nothing. Just thinking how lucky I am to have you. Your confidence gives me strength.
Flattery will get you everywhere. I'll tell the others of the plan.
Thank you.
Clive.
Lucas, were you able to confirm it?
Sadly, it is true. He's actually gone and done it.
Disgusting. I did not want to believe Desaye had it in him. All the more reason to put an end to his machinations here. This may be our final chance of holding on to Sophia and building her anew. And if we must sully our ha-
Clive! There you are! I'm trying to figure out which station I am to be posted at, but everyone just... am I interrupting something?
It's all right. We're finished here.
Thank you, Lucas.
Of course. I know what to do.
Clive, what is it? You look pale as a newly washed sheet. Has something happened?
Nothing you need trouble yourself with, dear sister. Come. I'll accompany you to your post.
Clive, look! Is that Fernand? Why in heaven's name is he just standing over there?
Again? Fernand, is everything all right? We must get to our stations before it's too late.
Hmm? Oh, yes. Of course.
I understand how you feel. The tragedy is still fresh in all our hearts. I cannot force you to fight on the front lines, but...
Enough! I said I'll go! Spare me the special treatment. It's insulting.
Fernand! We'll have none of that kind of talk. Can you see that Clive is simply worried about you?
How he must be hurting.
Yes, he's changed. He never used to snap at us like that. Now he does it all the time. Say anything to him at all, and he either ignores it or misconstrues it.
You can't blame him, Claire.
Nor do I blame him. The man has lost his entire family. It just breaks my heart. It's as if the Fernand we knew died along with them. And I want him back. I feel so powerless.
Well, I'm certain Fernand has noticed. He knows that you care. But time is all that can heal him now. We can give him that, can't we? We've known him since we were children. We have to remember how strong he is, and know he can overcome this trial.
Of course. You're right. I should not have yelled at him so. He didn't deserve it. I shall try harder to give him the space that he needs.
Good, then.
But just so you know, that means I'll be in your hair more often.
When are you not?
Hey, you and I both know I don't bother you all that much. You're lucky you have someone like me to keep you on your toes.
He is lucky indeed. And yet, who do I have left?
Gods, look at those numbers! I've never seen so many soldiers in one place.
Then I guess it's true. All the powerful houses have sworn allegiance to Desaye's camp. The damn cowards wouldn't even have noble titles without the king! And now they lick the boots of his murderer? Fie on them all!
I know what you're trying to say, but Lima wasn't exactly the best king. He spent his days stuffing his face and womanizing while his people starved. So, raise your hand if you weren't at least sort of thinking, good riddance. Hell, the nobles were just as happy to see him go as the starving commoners.
Please, don't ever say that in front of Sir Clive. Nothing excuses what they've done. Desaye and his sycophants have plunged Sophia into chaos.
You sure about that? Some would say it's the Deliverance what's plunging Sophia into chaos. We're the ones who chose to drag this war out, after all. Common folk don't give a whit which noble cheeks plop down on the throne. They just want to put bread on the table and continue drawing breath. How do you know they don't want us to lay down arms and let things be?
Python!
I'm just putting it out there. We'd be fools not to at least consider it. Be that as it may, they've a disgusting number of soldiers out there. Not even the castle walls will keep us safe forever.
Forsyth, Python. A moment, if I may.
Sir Lucas? What's the matter? This isn't your post.
Let's just say I have a problem that's weighing on my mind. And I'm thinking that the two of you might be able to help me with it.
Do go on.
Well, that kinda explains a lot about Fernand now. See what I mean? Why wasn't this on the main game? Seriously. It would have made Fernand's arc way more understandable. Alright, well, whatever. So, we have a lot of units here. Actually, not that many. I guess they were kind of exaggerating with that. Also, a defend map in Echoes. Is this really Echoes? Are we really playing the same game? All these maps with different objectives and stuff? Alright, I'm thinking it might be a wise idea to pluck these two sites. I might not get the terrain bonuses from the castle, but it will definitely thin out the numbers a lot better.
Allow me.
I think Matilda can outspeed all of these guys if she has a weapon equipped. No problem. This side has a mage, so I'm gonna send Matilda this way. I'm gonna send Clive this way.
Allow me.
And let me see something. These guys have 6 defense. Aldita has 11 attack. Yeah, Matilda is gonna need some heavyweights here.
Who among you will face me?
Leave this to me.
All Alright, I guess the rest can just come down here. Python can give some support from up here.
Nothing will stop me.
And Claire can be Claire, I guess. She does have a sweet cookie though, so I can probably trade that to somebody.
Attack! Cut those rebel scum into tiny rebel pieces! Let's see how long you last against a force this size, Sir Clive. I wager it won't be long at all.
Now Clive doesn't one-shot these guys either. Well then. We do have Python though, as long as he hits. As long as he hits. That's the keyword. Oh, actually I think he has the art. Yeah, he has curved shot, so I should probably abuse that. Alright, Clive. Start walling.
In the name of Sophia! No! For Sophia!
Who can hit me? Oh, the mage. You know, I'm gonna keep Lucas here for now because I actually don't want him to get hit by the mage. So we're gonna wait and see what the mage does. Let's get Fernand close so he can give bonuses to Clive. Alright. I don't think Foresight might be needed for now. Same for Claire. Alright. Finish him, not quite. I could have Claire finish him though.
I know, I'm simply terrible.
You can err in this chapter actually. Alright, I can hit the mage now though. I think the smart thing would be to do that instead. Just have Clive keep advancing.
No hard feelings. A shame. Every day a new lesson.
And then I can have Fernand, since Clive just killed this guy. Fernand trade the steel lens. Alright. I can keep Foresight close to give the leftover bread to somebody, I guess. Matilda's gonna need some healing. Pretty close.
I've seen enough. For Sophia!
Matilda doing Matilda things as usual.
Rest now.
Whoa. Nice shot there. Jeez.
Getting a little presumptuous.
Oh. That's kind of a bad miss. Would have been nice to damage the other guy too. Oh. Slade is coming this way. Oh shit. Oh, and the door is open. Oh, well. Well, this changes things a bit. Foresight, I'm gonna need you to block that entrance.
I'll do what I can.
Okay, you are not gonna get outspelled by them. But I kinda need a...
You bore me. Be gone.
I definitely need to heal Matilda.
Beggars can't be choosers.
I await your word. Die! No! Can't let him have all the glory.
Cap. Clive, wait here, and then I can send Fernand to help Matilda in this side. Yeah, that seems like a good idea. Alright. Matilda is gonna get pelted by three guys. Maybe four. Because how much do you do? Oh, you actually would kill on the counter. Yeah, let's do that. That sounds like a good idea, actually.
What's wrong? No thank you required.
Oh boy.
The proud kingdom you rabble sing of fell long ago. You just failed to notice. Now vacate that throne.
Oh man, we have a chance to actually kill Slade. Oh, this is very... I wonder what happens if we kill him actually. I mean, the mission is to defend, so I guess it wouldn't change the outcome. He probably has some dialogue though, which I definitely wouldn't mind to hear. Alright, first of all, I'm gonna give Claire back the... I mean, sorry, Matilda back the javelin. She can take one archer shot, pretty sure.
Leave this to me.
I can handle it.
Meanwhile, I can send Lucas back. Actually, I have a better idea. Clive, give me your... the steel lens. Whoa! Whoa! What the fuck happened to the horse there? He did like some standard shit from Fire Emblem Warriors right there. Alright. Yeah, let's give the steel lens to Matilda. Oh, this is gonna be great. Oh my god, what the hell was that, huh? Forslade, I still need you to come here. I guess Python can help me with a Slade on the other side. Oh no, come on! Don't block Slade. What turn are we? I didn't check. I kinda do want to kill him before this finishes. Oh shit, Clive is gonna have to back off. Matilda killed them? No, Matilda does not one round them. Oh man. I don't know if I will be able to kill Slade. I actually need to do some moving here. Alright, but I do need to make Clive back off. You know, Forza can wait here. That way he gets the benefits of the terrain and these guys don't. Alright, Python. He did it again! Oh my god, that's hilarious. I'll not be trifled with. I might use that as a thumbnail. That's way too funny. Gonna hit Clive this turn though. You know, I actually might. Can you outspeed him? No, you can't outspeed him. Damn. So Matilda is the only one that can actually try to kill him. Yeah, let's go for it. I wonder if Clive has a dialogue with him though. Hmm. Actually, you know what? Let's find out. We can have Matilda kill him next turn. Oh!
Farewell. Enough.
For the deliverance!
Gah, you wretched! Why do you cling to life when every one of you is already dead?
Good shit, Clive.
My eyes off you.
You just impressed Matilda. Good stuff. Him dying right there actually gives me the chance to block the mages now with Matilda. So we're gonna do this just that.
Beggars can't be choosers.
Let's give her the iron and stuff. Or maybe I should give her the javelin from Fernand next turn. Yeah, that might be a better idea. That way I don't put Claire in danger too. Alright. Yeah, Lucas, you go to a healing point. You are not needed anymore. We're in turn 7 too. We still have a couple of turns. Damn. I think the Clive's horse going into the wall gave him like super strength right now.
The gauntlets are off.
Freaking foresight.
No.
Did you think you had a chance?
This is a pretty fun map so far actually.
I'll not be trifled with.
Oh my god, again.
Enough.
Clive is gonna take the title of Kritilda from Kritilda.
Are you finished?
Oh. Okay, that's bad. We might need to back off. We are in turn 8 after all, so it wouldn't be a bad idea actually.
Leave this to me.
Yeah, Matilda can't kill these guys. Not in one round anyway. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2.
Shall I then?
Actually, I think Python can kill this guy? No, not quite. Alright. Lucas. Claire, you need to back off. You can sit there for a sec.
I've seen enough.
I think we're definitely gonna have to back off though. I kinda run. I think Forza is the only one that still has a healing item.
My turn.
Oh my god. Never mind. Kritilda is still Kritilda. Sorry, Clive, you're gonna need way more criticals to take her title. Oh, she's getting kinda low though. Yeah, we're definitely gonna have to back off.
Alright.
You guys fought a good fight, but unfortunately, as we know in the main game, the Sophia Castle does fall eventually, so just get out of here.
There. What? You're in my way!
This is what we call a tactical retreat.
These rebel dogs, they should have broken by now. Instead, they've decimated the troops Chancellor Desai entrusted to me. Now where the blasted hell are the rest of the men?
Sir Slade, the reinforcements have arrived.
About bloody time. Now we bury these worms for good and all. I will see them perish with agony and despair writ large upon their faces.
The enemy has ceased their attack. We've worn them down, it seems. Well done, everyone. If they're wise, they will withdraw and regroup.
No, Clive. Look!
Reinforcements? Damn. They weren't revealing their whole hand.
It's worse than that, Clive. Look closer. Look at the banners.
Those are Regellian soldiers. Desaye has sold out his own kingdom.
Listen close, rebels! Even oafs such as you are clever enough to know what these banners mean. In the name of the Kingdom of Zofia, Chancellor Desaye has secured an alliance with the Regellian Empire. Do you understand me now? Shall I spell it out with small words? Regel has formally acknowledged that the Chancellor is Zofia's true ruler. That means there's no one left to legitimize your pathetic little band. Now, relinquish the castle! That dastard son of a milkless sow! Did Regicide truly not sate his appetite? We should have seen this coming!
Well, Clive, this is a sorry spot. Our soldiers are already weary from battle, while Regel's reinforcements appear to be fresh as daisies, which means our choices are to surrender and be put to the sword, or make our stand and fight against hopeless odds to the last man. Make what decision you will. Either outcome is the same to me.
Fernand, listen to yourself!
No, Claire. It's over. But I swear to you this. Clive, Matilda, and myself will parley with Slade. We will offer our lives in exchange for your safety. Although you may prefer death to whatever life they give you.
Are you mad? I don't want any of us to die.
Especially not me. I mean, since we're all being honest.
Can't you muster even a little class in your final hour? We are the Deliverance. So long as we still draw breath, we will fight.
It's a waste of breath to fight a battle you can't win. What we really need is an escape plan. Mayhap we start thinking about that?
I agree with Python.
Lucas, not you! I thought you were... Wait, hold on, is this why you asked us to... Oh!
Clive, is it time?
I assumed Desaye was still a noble, still a knight. I assumed there was a line even he would not cross. But I see now I was a fool to place trust in such a man.
You're no fool. It is never folly to believe in the underlying goodness of people. Those are the ideals that make Zofia a kingdom worth fighting for. But to preserve those ideals, we must compromise on others.
Do as you must.
I would have your answer, rebels! Do not be frightened now. Good Sir Slade is a man of mercy. Grovel on the ground before me, and I may yet spare your lives. Just so long as you are prepared to live out your lives as slaves.
Wait, up there! Sir Slade, something is happening. Look to the ramparts!
Don't interrupt me in the middle of my speech, idiot! I was just getting to... What? No, it can't be! Ugh. Those are the Regellians who were living in the city! But that's impossible! I warned them of the siege myself!
Do you understand now, Slade? Or shall I use small words? The Deliverance has rounded up every last Regellian in Zofia. It seems you told them to escape. A sensible tactic, of course. It wouldn't do to anger a new ally by putting their people in danger. But did you really think we wouldn't notice them scurrying away like rats? A mass exodus of Regellians is rather easy to spot. I do wonder how you managed to get word to them, but it matters little now. Clearly, it would be unwise for the Deliverance to stay here in the castle. So, we shall hand it over to you, just as you asked. However, you and your men are going to grant us safe passage. That is the bargain. If you do not keep this bargain, we will behead every last Regellian in our care. Do you agree to our terms?
those dastards!
I'd say kill them all and let the Regellians hang, but I can't risk Rudolph's ire.
Damn that Clive to hell! I thought he had honor! But again, he thwarts me just as I'm about to put him in his place! One day, I will choke the very life from him and all of his followers! I swear it!
Clive? Brother?
Leave him be, Claire. The stone of that castle was half of what held up his pride. Now it's gone. As a knight and leader of the Deliverance, he is wounded. And even I don't know how gravely.
I too am wounded, Lady Matilda. What if that was the last time we ever walk the castle halls? I can't bear to think that the only way to return there is in memory.
All of us are hurting, Claire. All of us.
At times like this, I feel like such an outsider.
Welcome to Python's world. But forget that. I'm still all a quiver from watching Lucas's performance. He's so down to earth that I keep thinking he's one of us. But pulling a stunt like that takes true knightly courage.
I'll say. Perhaps such a disposition is something one is simply born into.
Uh-oh, did I touch a nerve? Look, I know you want to be a knight, but it ain't gonna happen. You should just make peace with the idea like I have.
I will do no such thing! I know what I'm capable of! I will be a knight, Python! Just you watch!
Mercy, brave Sir Forsyth! Mercy! I shouldn't have said anything. Besides, even without a king to anoint you and a castle to serve in, you already have a magnificent knightly future ahead of you.
Well, yes, I'm glad you... Gods, I hate you sometimes.
Explain yourself, Lucas. Forgive me, Fernand, but I'm not sure what you're talking about.
Don't play daft! Why didn't you tell me about the Regellion sneaking out of the city? Do you fancy yourself Clive's new confidant now?
No. I simply surmised that the plan was more likely to succeed if few knew of it. This is why I didn't tell Matilda, and you don't see her shouting about it.
Have you no shame? Taking hostages like some barbarian. You've dragged the Deliverance's name through the mud with your actions. Is that what they teach bumpkin boys in lieu of honor? Ha! You're a disgrace.
I thought we were fighting for something greater than appearances. And while I understand your concerns, and perhaps even share them, I would kindly ask you control your emotions and look at the bigger...
Still your tongue or I'll tear it free!
Clive sanctioned these measures. Do you question him? Now excuse me, Fernand. I have a report to make. We should begin by seeking refuge in the shrine to the southwest. The hideout our expeditionary teams use should still be well supplied. Clive, are you listening?
Yes, of course. Apologies, Lucas. Once again, my burdens have become yours to bear.
And I take them up gladly. Just promise that your melancholy will vanish with the dawn. On the morrow, we must begin devising a strategy to retake the castle.
Lucas.
Yes?
I feel as though I am only just now truly getting to know you. To be blunt, I assumed you joined the Deliverance on your brother's orders. That you were forced to enlist.
You have the right of it. This is not the path I chose. But I have no home to return to. So I intend to see where the path leads. Do not mistake me for a man who needs pity. If I die along a road I never chose, then so be it. I will still die with pride, and not regret. I have sworn you my lance, and it will not waver.
I know, Lucas.
There is righteousness in your heart, Clive. A strain of it that I lack. I believe this righteousness is the light that will save Sophia. There are many who believe what I believe, and we look to you now. So when you have finished mourning your past, leave it behind.
I shall try. Thank you, Lucas. I will be all right. But...
What is it?
You said light.
It reminded me of the hero in the prophecy.
What, that old children's tale?
The very same. When darkness envelops the world, a hero shall come to smite all evil. Where is that hero now, I wonder?
I see your point. The world has never been darker. What do you imagine our hero is doing at this very moment?
Sleeping, if he's wiser than us. But until he appears, we shall just have to keep crawling through the mud, fighting however many mindless battles it takes to prevail. Come, let us press on to the shrine and determine our next move.
Lead the way, my friend.
Man, why was this not the prologue of the main game? Seriously, this kinda set it up so perfectly. That was pretty good. Freaking Lucas though. Lucas is a savage. Life's lens. It's like a stronger steel lens. Has armor crush and two other skills that I can't see right now. Yeah, man, I'm so sad that this is DLC. This could have worked so well as the actual prologue of the game, rather than the tutorial prologue that we got. But oh well. That was Rise of the Deliverance. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I sure did. And there isn't really other DLCs I'm interested in. Like, I don't really care about the Cypher Legends, and I heard their DLC is also pretty easy, especially with an endgame team, so I don't think I'm gonna get that one. So I guess this is probably the last Fire Emblem Echoes video, unless I decide to post some of the stream archives I have done on Twitch. I will see. But yeah, thanks a lot for watching, guys, and I will see you in another game or maybe some other Fire Emblem stuff. Who knows? Thanks for watching. Oh, and I almost forgot about Lucas' shield. Looks like a stronger steel shield. Probably has Choven something and other stuff. But yeah, that's it. Thanks for watching.